Andy, Mike, what the way this thing unfolds is when you're talking about Vivoleum, you're actually showing this group of 300 oil men a 3D animation, right? You're showing them, this is how we've taken the body this is how we've taken the body of the janitor and reduced it to Vivoleum. Is that basically it?
That's it. And there's I think some of the design of the Vivoleum facilities were based on earlier designs historically that were built in order to turn people into various kinds of rendered material. Yeah, you can read between the lines if you want. I don't know.
Okay, so at any rate, they say at some point somebody figures out this is even outrageous for ExxonMobil. So let's get these guys off stage. They put you in a holding cell, and they believe that you're going to be arrested. But the Mountie, yeah. I guess the Canadian Mounties basically laugh at it, see how ridiculous the whole thing is, and say, yeah, there's nothing's happened here. There's nothing to arrest these guys about.
That's right. And they did try to just let us go, but the organizers insisted the cops give us trespassing tickets.
Yeah.
So the cops gave us trespassing tickets, knowing that was pretty ridiculous. And in fact, the court just threw them out before it could come to trial. We really wanted to go to trial for trespassing.
Were there people in the audience that were buying into this? I mean, that were saying, yeah, let's light the candle here.
There were definitely people buying into it. I mean, but it was a little bit harder to buy into the smell of the candle because they actually put human hair in the candle. So when they were burning, they really created a stench.
Okay. All right. So somebody, at least people in the audience are saying, you know, this is not a bad idea, right? We take dead people that we've killed by way of climate change. And it's a process that just it gins itself up. It perpetuates itself, right?
Yeah. I mean, it's a self-feeding sort of mechanism. You know, we're killing the planet. We're going to cause climate change catastrophes. You better be prepared to do something about it. And there's going to be a lot of fuel left over.
What do you think? Again, the concept is mockumentary. I mean, and again, it's you have your own thing here. But it is kind of a merger between what Michael Moore does and Barat and 2020. I just think it's just extremely creative. What do you think you accomplished in that?
Well, one of the things we accomplished, I think, is to make people laugh and go see a lot of really horrible things that are happening around the world, but while laughing. And, you know, they'll enjoy themselves in the movie, and they'll find out at the same time that, you know, Dow hasn't cleaned up Bhopal, that companies are driving us off the cliff of climate change and really don't care. And,
yeah,
you know.
Yeah, yeah. Well, how about Survivaball? Tell us the Survivaball story.
Oh, boy. Well,
I love Survivaball.
We went to something called a catastrophic loss conference in Florida, and we represented Halliburton there. And we basically announced plans that Halliburton had to save the top managers and owners of companies from climate change by making these special balls for them to live in, a kind of gated community for one. And they're called Survivaballs. And we actually made these ridiculous costumes that are, you know, they're about 6 feet in diameter, and they inflate. And we put three of the main conference hosts in the costumes and inflated them in front of the audience.
Wait, just a second. Wait, the people that invited you there, you invited them up on stage and put them in a Survivaball?
Yeah, I mean, they were really friendly.
Okay, and the Survivaball is something only that the richest of the rich can buy. In other words, this is something that the average person can't buy. The average schmuck out there can never afford a Survivaball, but very rich people can.
Yeah, and the basic idea is that when we've completely annihilated the Earth from climate change, the very richest people can still go on living in these insulated, you know, self-contained units.
So basically they're bouncing around a destroyed world. Catastrophe takes place, and they're bouncing around the world fat, rich, and happy, correct?
Their Survivaball. We don't know if they're happy, but we know that they're fat and rich.
All right. Well, let me ask you, where are you going with all this? Does this get to the point, like with Barrett, to where nobody will let you in the meetings, or Michael Moore, where he can't, there's no way he can get into a meeting anymore? He used to be able to do that with Ford and some of these other big companies, but now he can't. Doesn't it get there at some point when they start seeing Andy and Mike coming, they say, we've seen this before?
It hasn't happened yet. But, at the same time, this isn't rocket science, and a lot of people could be doing this. In fact, just next week, we're going to be launching a special kind of game, challenge sort of game on our website, where we're going to be helping to spread these techniques that we use to get into these conferences and go on TV and so on, make it just fully transparent. People can come and do it. And
in other words, you're going to arm other people and create other Andy and Mikes out there that might want to do this in their local community.
Well, we certainly hope they're not Andy and Mikes, but
definitely can't be.
Ones
that are doing, a lot of people are doing things like this already. We're not the first. We won't be the last. There's a lot going on right now. But I got to tell you something, Mike.
I don't know that they're doing it with as much social responsibility. You see a lot of scams. You see a lot of funny scams out there. All you got to do is go to the net, and you see a lot of funny stuff. But I don't know that they're done with the kind of goal, of meaningful goal, of some social responsibility that y'all are doing here. And I think that's why it's such a great program. I think that's why, I hope y'all can get away with this for the next 10 years and make a lot of money doing it.
Only 10?
Yeah.
We hope so too.
Yeah. So your next project really is going to be to just we don't know the next project. You can't tell us the next project, but hopefully you're going to show up on the screen again with something as funny as Vivoleum, or something as ridiculous as your Dow chemical spokesperson, or something as absurd as a survival ball. We'll be waiting, okay?
All right. Well, we've got a lot of plans, and we'll let you know when they hatch.
Yeah, they're gonna have. There's a bunch of stuff happening in September. I'll give you a hint. It's around the climate change negotiations that are going to be taking place at the UN, September 20th. And if you want to find out, and if you want to join in, especially, which is more important, go to the yesmen.org.
All right, we'll do that.
Sign up there, or go to beyondtalk.net if you want to get arrested. beyondtalk.net, for real.
Andy, Mike, thanks a lot, guys. Okay, good work.
Thank you.
Well, joining us live from Paris now is Jude Finisterre. He's a spokesman for Dow Chemicals.
Today, I'm very happy to announce that for the first time, Dow is accepting full responsibility for the Bhopal catastrophe.
This interview was inaccurate.
The hoax was an elaborate one. The prank knocked 3% of Dow shares.
Well, I wouldn't say it's a hoax. It's an honest representation of what Dow should be doing.
Louisiana officials are taken for a ride by the Yes Men.
The Yes Men?
The Yes Men travel the world pulling pranks at corporate events.
My name is Fred. I'm from Halliburton.
My name is Francisco Guerrero.
I'm Northrop Goody.
I'm with the World Trade Organization.
Erastus Hand is going to be speaking.
Ooh!
Sick. Twisted.
I say you're a liar.
My name's Mike.
I'm Andy. This is a movie in which the two of us
fix the world.
We want something that's going to be able to save a human being no matter what Mother Nature throws at him. And so this is the Halliburton Survival Ball.
We'll be happy to take any questions.
Without oil, at least 4 billion people would starve, and starving would become the new black.
Expecting the next knock at the door to be Dow's lawyer.
No idea what Dow will do. They threatened us.
Are you allowed to do that to me?
We are preparing to go to the Gulf Coast Reconstruction Conference, and CNN is going to be covering it live.
ExxonMobil is earmarking $8.6 billion to finance wetlands rebuilding.
Hold on, a heck of a hoax.
Thank you.
Maybe it'll take a whole slide, dear.
is to bring them out here to see what we're going through.
I thought that was a wonderful thing to do.
This is actually truth-telling, where normally there would only be lies.
If you could demonstrate the turtle position, please, that would be great.